All right, so as you can see, it's another unboxing of another LTM 1750. I happened to come across a guy on Instagram that was selling some models, and he asked me where he could sell them. And I told him a Facebook page, and I asked him what models he had. And he had a few different cranes, and one of them was a Atlas LTM 1750, which is very limited. I'm not really 100% sure how many were made, but I know that most of the Atlas company took a lot of them. I want to say only like 50 of these went to the collectors. But anyway, I thought this one looked really, really nice. Here's the spreader bar. But he bought two of them at once. And he sold it. Here's the spreader bar. The yellow one yellow crane comes with a yellow bar. I'm sure you've seen the unboxing video of that one. It's all the same. Here's counterweight tray. All the same stuff, just different paint. Looks really good. So I'm going to sell my, well, I already sold it, but I'm selling the yellow one because I don't really need it or want it. Been wanting the all crane version, but they haven't came out with it yet. Plastic wrap stuck to it. Outrigger base plates. Counterweights. One thing I've noticed about the model and the real version of this crane is the power pack or winch pack. The real one is white. So, not really sure what happened there. But, either way, it still looks good. There's walkways. Here's Here's your three sheet block. Here's the big block, like 11 sheaves, I think. 9 sheaves. And here's the caps for the counterweight. Nuts and bolts and pins, outrigger pads. Leave them all in the box of the bag. Here's your winch keys, ladders. Over here is the super lift. One thing different about this one is from mine is the pulley holders. So on mine, the yellow one, which was the first edition, you weren't able to clip these onto the super lift. But they modified that. It looks like it's riveted on there. So you can't take them off. I don't know if you can tell on the camera. But it's a rivet. But they should stay on there anyway. They don't need to come off. The drums on these seem a little bit tighter than the one I had on the yellow one. So that's pretty good. But yeah, they just sit on their storage holders. Here's the other pendant bars. And the crane. Which looks really, really nice. Something came off. Suspension piece. It's not broke, it just come off. Glue didn't stick or something. This out of the way. There's the crane. It looks super good. I really like it. And here's the yellow one. And it has a super lift on it. I really like this white, the white and gray, and it's got the chrome rims. I mean, the yellow one looks good, but I don't know, there's just something about the white. don't know if you can really see the super lift bracket. Camera's not wanting to focus. Maybe if I zoom in a little bit. There you go. See, there's a rivet. This one's just screwed on. There's a screw right there. A bigger screw. And it's not attached to the super lift at all. But this rivet is all the way through, so you can put the screw through to attach the super lift. It really looks good. I really hope they come out with the all version, because I still want that one, just because I've seen it in person. Like I said, these were very limited. I want to say like maybe 50 or 100 maybe. Only went to collectors and the company. I think only maybe two other collectors I know that have this crane, maybe three. Have this version. So when he said he had it, I just couldn't let it go. I had to get it. Ever since I saw the pictures of it, I thought it looked really nice. And I was kind of regretting getting the yellow one, because I would have got it anyway, this Atlas version. I'll get some pictures up on the Facebook page and in model groups or whatever. So, and Instagram. So, here's the unboxing. It's all pretty much the same as the other unboxing, just different color crane. It has a couple different features like the super lift and the boom. It's got the painted boom, the black and the name. The yellow one's just gray. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.